ever been mesmerised by topographic texture, those intricate lines on maps, and wondered how to bring that cool aesthetic into your designs? Then you're in the right place. Topographic textures are not just visually stunning, they add depth and a unique vibe to your projects. Whether you're working on branding, posters, or even digital art, these textures can transform ordinary designs into eye-catching pieces of art. And the best part, you can create them in just 3 simple steps, which can take you between 5 to 10 minutes to create. So whether you're a beginner or a pro, stick around because this tutorial is going to help you get some cool topographic texture into your work. So let's get into it. So here I am in Illustrator, and these are some topographic textures I have created earlier. Here I have a couple of examples of some different approaches I have taken, where some are more concentrated than others. Some have really dense stroke lines and some have lighter strokes with more space between. So at this point, it's really important to mention that there are other ways of doing this and some other tutorials online using Photoshop. But what makes this one different is that we are only using Illustrator, and this one gives you maximum control of your creative outcome. For example, here we have an example with letters where you can craft and make a topographic texture out of bespoke shapes. This is a very versatile technique we are about to use, where you can keep it really dense or you can be quite light with it and really control your shapes. So very flexible. Now, if I zoom into these, we can see the awesome textures. All of these strokes are separate, so I can change the stroke weight, add dashes, and change the color and even edit them. So some really cool topographic compositions here I have created from scratch. Now, check this out. So here is another document demonstrating the steps that it takes in order to create this effect. Now, unfortunately, you can't just click a button and make this effect. It's going to take a little bit of crafting, but thankfully not too much, which is actually quite nice because you can make this your own and be really creative with it. This is very easy to achieve within 5 to 10 minutes, and it only takes 3 steps. In the first step, you will need to draw some organic shapes. This is where you get to have maximum control. This can be random or it can be to your exact design. In the second step, you apply the topographic effect, and in the third step, you refine the strokes. So let's go ahead and create a topographic texture using these steps. So the first step, draw some organic shapes. So I'll create a new document. Now you can choose whichever canvas size you want to go with, but for this example, I'm just going to go with a portrait canvas. And for this step, the pencil tool is your friend. Now we can either come over to the tools menu, click and hold and select the pencil tool, or we can use the keyboard shortcut N on the keyboard. To begin, we will need to create our first shape. So I'll start by drawing a large organic shape. Now the trick here is to draw a shape that is not too complicated, but with a bit of flair. You want to get some nice smooth contours in your shape. Now, when using the pencil tool, you will start by drawing a line, and when you come back to the beginning of the line and release with your mouse, it should snap to join the stroke together. Now, once you've drawn your first shape, we can immediately begin to draw the second, but a couple of tricks here to keep in mind. If there is part of the line that you're not happy with, there are a couple of things you can do to smooth it out. With the direct selection tool, you can click the line, and if you click and hold on the pencil tool, you can select the smooth tool and then draw over your stroke to smooth it out. Personally, I love this one. I find this an excellent tool to help smooth out my lines. Another way is to select shape, come up to object, down to path, and hit simplify, or hit smooth and toggle the values. So once you've got your first shape, we're just going to draw another shape. One technique to keep in mind here is for the next shapes, try and start next to the previous shape by drawing close to it, imitating the contours of the shape, and come away to create the rest of it. The goal is to create a connection between the shapes so they loosely gel together. Now, depending on what you want to achieve, you can keep these really close together or you can keep them further apart. Keep in mind, the more organic you are and the more spontaneous you are, the more interesting your topographic effect is going to be. So to complete the first step, we need to fill this canvas area with organic shapes. I'll continue drawing my shapes, again, keeping in mind to draw them similar to each other, creating a relationship between them. And I can use the techniques to smooth my lines. And after a couple of minutes, I'll have something that looks like this. So to draw these shapes just took me a few minutes. Once you have a composition you're happy with, we can move on to the next step where we can apply the topographic effect. Now, I'm not going to apply the topographic effect to the shapes here because I want to use these shapes again later to create a different composition. So I'll come over to the Tools panel and click the Artboard panel. I'll click on the Artboard, press and hold Alt plus Shift on the keyboard, and duplicate the Artboard across with its contents. So this is where the magic happens. So I'll select all the shapes. In the Tools menu, I'll set the Stroke color to transparent, and for the Fill color, I'll just choose one of the light gray options from the Swatches panel. I'll then come up to Effect, down to 3D and Materials, and across to Inflate. And this will add a 3D effect to all of our shapes, and you can see here the shadows. In the settings, I'm going to push up the depth all the way up to max it out. I'll push the volume up to max it out. And then I'm simply going to come down to the bottom and click Expand as Wireframes. And boom, we have applied the topographic effect. Awesome, right? Well, that's great, but right now it's a bit raw and dense. Next, I'm going to need to do a little bit of finessing to get the effect I want. So now we're going to move to the third and final step, which is to finesse these stroke lines and get them looking just how we want them. So I'm not going to edit directly onto this mood board because there's going to be a lot of changes I'm about to make, and I might want to refer back to these samples later. So again, I'm going to come into the Tools menu, grab the Artboard tool, click on this Artboard, and while holding Alt and Shift, I'm going to click and drag to the right to duplicate the Artboard. And with the Selection tool, I'm going to select over all my new shapes. I'm going to come to the Stroke panel and set the weight to 1. And now I have some very dense strokes. All we're going to do here is spend the next couple of minutes to just refine the strokes. And to do this, I'm going to use the Direct Selection tool. I'm going to zoom in. With the Direct Selection tool, I'll just click on a stroke, and with it selected, I'll just press Delete twice to get rid of it. So I'm now going to repeat this process. I'll click on a stroke line, press Delete twice to remove, and I'll just go around my shapes, deleting some of the strokes. A technique I find useful here is to delete every other stroke line. The qualities of the topographic effect is that there can be interesting spaces between lines. If you want a complex effect, you can leave the strokes. But if you want to create a minimal effect, you can delete more strokes. So I'll spend the next couple of minutes just going around my composition. Now, sometimes when you use this effect, some of the stroke lines are not particularly smooth. Sometimes you can get random lines that are a bit more complicated. So keep in mind, if there are any stroke lines that you're not happy with, you can use the smooth techniques as demonstrated earlier. You can either use the smooth tool or use simplify or the smooth feature in object path. So I'll continue to remove some of the stroke lines and smooth out some of them until I have something that looks like this. And it's starting to look more like a classic topographic effect. Nice. So that's how you can create a topographic effect. One of the best reasons for creating this topographic effect like this is that every stroke is editable. Now, if you want to go further, we can duplicate the artboard across, create a solid shape, send it to the back, select all the stroke lines, change them to white, and with the Direct Selection tool, you can zoom in and click on some of the lines, come into the stroke panel, add some dashes. You can come to some of the stroke lines and increase the stroke size, change the color to your preference, and with a bit more crafting, you can create a really interesting effect with more depth. So here are some more examples I've created earlier, and you can see here there's quite a few effects you can achieve. Also, I have a topographic texture pack with a variety of topographic textures you can use in your work. If you want to take a closer look at this Illustrator document with all the samples and get hold of the topographic texture pack, you can acquire them as part of the poster design ebook. So that is how you can create a topographic effect in Adobe Illustrator. Pretty easy, right? Well, in my next video, I demonstrate how you can use this texture effect to create a vibrant music festival poster design in Illustrator. If you're interested to learn how to create a vibrant music festival poster using this topographic effect, check the link in the description. Well, I hope you enjoyed this tutorial. If you did, hit the like button and don't forget to subscribe and hit the bell button to be notified of more tutorial videos like this in future. Now, this tutorial was created for all my members of the GDS Design School community. If you would like to join the GDS Design School community, where we chat about design, give each other feedback, and where I set design challenges, you're all welcome to join for free. Again, the link is in the description, and I look forward to seeing you there. So until my next design tutorial, unleash your creativity, and I'll see you next time.